smooth, and we'll just take a moment. Settle into the breath. Inhaling and exhaling through the nose, if it's comfortable. Try and fill up the belly like a balloon. Exhaling to release all tension. Next inhale, we're going to slowly start to roll the head, draw circles with the crown of the head. Nice and slow and steady. Welcome, welcome if you're just joining in. Slowly roll the neck. Change direction. Nice and steady. We carry a lot of tension in the neck and shoulders, so pre-bed it's a good place to start. Next inhale, bring the head back to center, the gaze is forward. So we're going to draw the shoulders up, then roll them back and down. Nice and slow and steady. There's no rush. Change direction when it feels right. Left side of the head and just gently draw ear to shoulder. So make sure that we're bringing the it is ear to shoulder, we're not hunching the shoulder up towards the ear. Find that stretch. Close the eyes here. Whatever helps prepare you for your good night's sleep. Next inhale, we're going to switch it to the other side. So left hand comes to the right side of the head now. And we draw ear to shoulder. Only very gently, just a little bit of encouragement. In the breath, we want to maintain a really nice, slow and steady rhythm. On an exhale, we're going to bring left palm to the right knee and the right hand comes behind. As we inhale, we're sitting up nice and tall. As we exhale, we're twisting through, keeping the hips facing the front, nice and square. Twist through the torso. Gaze comes over the right shoulder, or if the neck's still a little bit stiff, just gaze straight ahead. Inhale, reach the arms up and overhead one more time. Exhaling to twist to the opposite side. Right hand to left knee, left hand behind. Again, drawing up through the crown of the head. Sit nice and tall. But press both hips into the mat so they remain nice and square. Then next inhale, we reach up one last time. Find that nice stretch, wiggle fingers. Exhale, cactus the arms down, so reaching down with the elbows. And then we bring ourselves to our tabletop. Knees underneath the hips, wrists underneath the shoulders, and we're going to bring in our cat-cow. Inhaling to send the crown of the head, the tailbone up. Exhale, tucking them under. Moving in time with your breath. Then next inhale, bring it back to center. We're going to place the left hand in front and we're going to open up to the right hand side. Exhaling to thread through but keeping the shoulder raised off the mat. So we'll take a few dynamic here, nice and slow. With the left shoulder here, and we want to make sure that the hips remain stacked above the knees. Just check in to see if they've taken a little sway. Shoulder. Again, option to raise the right hand, bring it to the lower back, or even round to the left thigh. Check in with the hips, and then really open the chest, pulling up with that right shoulder. Crunch with the neck so don't hunch up. Really try and extend as much as you can here. Mm-hmm.
Next, inhale, we reach back over with the right hand,
press it up and open up. Then exhale, we come into our puppy pose. So we reach the hands out in front and we lower the chest down towards the mat, stacking the hips above the knees. Chin can come to the mat or we can bring the forehead down. Toes to touch and press the knees to the outer edges of the mat, coming back into our child's pose as we lower the forehead down to the mat. Finding that length in the spine. Inhale, walk the hands over to the left and then exhale to lower down, finding a stretch in the right side body. Reaching with the fingertips and pressing down into the heels and with the glutes. Stretching our left side body. Two breaths in our child's pose. And then we'll inhale nice and steady as we come up, preparing to come into our downward facing dog. So we inhale, curl the toes under, check that the hands are shoulder width apart before we exhale.
Sending the tailbone up nice and high, finding that hip tilt. Pedal out the legs. And this is sort of as high up off the mat as we're going to come this evening. We keep a nice low profile as we're getting ready for bed. Next inhale, we need to plant the left foot down, raise the right foot up, and then exhale to plant it between the hands. Lower the back knee, find your low lunge. Our hands can come to the waist, on the hips, or either side of the foot. I want you to just sink the hips down.
keeping them nice and square. Now, if you spent the day sort of working from home, sat at a desk, then you'll probably feel a nice stretch in your, you'll feel a stretch in your hip flexors, the front of the thigh here. If it's not quite getting there, you can lift the left arm up here and just take a slight bend over towards the right. That can help find it. Or another option is to fold the mat under this back knee and then draw the left heel towards the left glutes. Take hold and find a stretch. You'll feel a nice, fairly intense, quite deep quad stretch, but also the hip flexors here. Reconnect with the breath. Inhale here and then exhale. Plant the hands down. We're then going to walk the right foot out just to the edge of the mat. Bring the foot to a 45 degree angle, roll it onto the outside if that's more comfortable, and then take the right hand, place it on the thigh, and just open that right hip out a little bit. To lower down onto the forearms here, as long as we keep the chest open, lengthen the spine. And we're going to toe heel the foot across to the opposite side of the mat to come into our pigeon pose. Now, if you find this tricky, be careful that you don't try and rest the knee in front of the hip, okay? We want to find some lateral rotation or external rotation here. So the knee actually comes slightly outside of the hip. Press through the toes of that back leg and then bring the left hip so it's square with the right and lower it down. You'll find that hopefully you're a little bit more comfortable coming into pigeon. Option as well to use a block or bolster, cushion, anything underneath that right thigh to assist. But as long as we have the hips nice and square, then we're not going far wrong. Stay up on the hands, lower to forearms, or even take it all the way down if it's comfortable for you. Remember, we're actively trying to draw this left hip down, okay? So that's where you find the stretch in the right glutes. Try and melt the hips down into the mat. Last breath here. And then we'll inhale to come up onto the hands, releasing the foot, the right foot that is. Give it a little bit of a shake out behind. And then we're going to come through tabletop to press back up into our downward facing dog.
Pedaling out the legs, taking a little bit of time Take any movement here which feels good. And then when you're ready, we're going to come and do the same thing on the left side. So we'll inhale to plant the right foot. The left foot comes up, and then we exhale it between the hands, lowering the back knee, finding your low lunge. Again, the hips are square, the chest is open. We're sinking the hips down, finding that stretch in the front of the right thigh, particularly the hip flexors. Remember, you can extend the right arm overhead. Take a slight lean, engage the core if you're doing so. Glutes are engaged here, particularly this right hip, because we're extending it back. And if you can't quite find the stretch there, once again, we can bring the right heel up, this time towards the right glutes, take hold of the ankle. And find that deeper stretch. Place something underneath that back knee if it's uncomfortable. Or alternatively, you can just stay in the low lunge. Take an inhale in your low lunge, exhale, send the hips down. And one more inhale here. Exhale, just plant the right hand and then walk the left foot out to the edge of the mat, 45 degrees. Roll onto the outside of the foot and gently just encourage a little bit of hip opening. Rotation of the thigh, so the knee comes slightly outside the hips and feels more comfortable. It's completely up to you how your anatomy and whatever, where it, whether your foot is close in towards the groin or you try and find that right angle almost. Once again, we can come up onto the toes of that back foot to draw the right hip forward, squaring them off before we lower it down. This time we actively draw right hip down to the mat and we feel the stretch in our left glutes. Once again, block, bolster, whatever can be placed under that thigh to assist.
release the left leg back, give it a nice shake out. And once again, pressing up and back into our downward facing dog.
Take three breaths here. Onto the balls of the feet, exhaling to bring the knees to the outer edges of the mat, big toes touch, press it back into your child's pose.
Next inhale, we can keep a low profile, we're going to draw the chest forward so we can briefly to lay on our tummies, and then roll over onto our backs, bringing the soles of the feet to touch, finding our reclined butterfly, Baddha Konasana. Rest the hands, palms facing up, just next to the legs. Allow the eyelids to feel heavy as they close. Relax the face. Relax the neck. Bring the tongue down from the roof of the mouth if it's found its way there. And then visualize walking towards your bed. Putting the covers back and then stepping into bed, putting the covers up and over you, the head sinks into the pillow. From the day dissipates with each exhale. And you know you're going to have a really good night's sleep. Two rounds of our our square breathing. So we will inhale for four, hold the breath for four, exhale for a count of four, and then pause before taking our second cycle through for a count of four. When you're ready, center, bring the thumbs up towards the third eye.